Hey, what's going on? Tony here from learnautobodyandpaint.com. Thank you guys for getting on tonight. I am just waiting for the video to populate on my computer screen here to make sure I'm seeing something. I would love if you could give me quick feedback. Let me know if you see my audio and if you hear my audio and if you see my video. If you could quickly type in the chat, I want to make sure that, what's up, Aunt Dog? I want to make sure that you guys hear me and see me. Quickly, give me some feedback. All good. Great. Everything's okay. All good, bro. Thank you so much. Because sometimes you guys don't hear me for some reason. I got to restart the computer. But fortunately, I did that before I got on. So I'm on the laptop right now, streaming with laptop. The video, I assume, is not as clear as my iPhone when I was streaming live. But I needed to do this so I could interact with you a little bit better and doing this pinstriping. So I made a video a few days ago about pinstriping hacks, right? And I just gave you some tips. I actually goofed up on the front, so I didn't have any front design on. I was just giving you tips on how to measure it, a couple of hacks, but this is more of a full-on, I'm gonna pinstripe it. So you guys are gonna see me live and do that. Do you guys wanna see me do this, or do you wanna do something else? Because I was figuring I can just do a quick live demo here. We could start on the cab or we can start on the bed, whatever you want. You guys vote it in and I will do it. I was thinking to actually complete the half arrow that I wanted to do there, do the pinstripe and then do the back, all right? And I wanted to kind of curve in with the body here, with the back, come across the four-road decal here, and do something cool on the back. So it's up to you. It's basically two parts. We can do the cab or the bed. I don't care. We could start with either or. Whatever you guys want to do. Pinstriping sounds good. Okay. And guys, the pinstriping that I'm going to be using here is Prostripe. Okay. This is easy DIY pinstripe. I like to do it, like I said on my other live stream, pinstriping by hand and by painting pinstripe is a whole nother art in itself. You need years of practice, and I don't have years of practice. I have years of practice with auto body, but not with pinstriping. I have years of practice with this. I've done this to many cars. I like this stuff. It's easy. If you goof up, you could peel it back off and start all over. The only thing you lose is a little bit of material, all right? You don't even lose time, like I say, because you're learning with every goof up or every step that you make, you're learning something. So I'm using Prostripe. I love this. They have probably at least 100 different colors and sizes, at least. And they've been around for a long time, okay? So let's get started. Oh, before we do that, I just wanna get a quick survey. Yeah, they sell them in many different colors. In fact, let me just show you guys some of the colors. I had a box of it, but one day while I was moving, I left a box in the sun and it melted a lot of my pinstriping and just made everything go bad. So for instance, I have gold over here. I don't know if you see the gold. There's hundreds of different colors, like I said, at least 100. Here is some metal flake pinstripe, and they also come in different thicknesses. The one that I'm using right now, the most popular, is 5/16. I think all of the ones I have here are about 5/16, and they come in about 150 feet. So you could do a couple of cars with this, no problem. A couple of cars. All right, super easy. So, yeah, I wanted to do a quick survey. How many VIPs in the house? How many VIPs in the house? Type in VIP. And also, if you're a VIP, don't forget to hit the thumbs up. If you're anybody on here watching, don't forget to hit the thumbs up. You can buy this stuff off of eBay. I buy mine in packs off of eBay. Sergio, Jonathan, Danny D, VIP, John, VIP, Ricardo, John again, VIP, a lot of VIPs in the house. Welcome, guys, welcome. I love to see you on tonight. I'm happy that you made it. And I hope I can finish this in 20 minutes. If not, we will go overtime. And if you guys have to bail out, then bail out. You know, I understand. My feelings won't be hurt. But you could always come on it and watch the replay. So what is VIP? VIP is Learn Auto. They're basically VIP members at learnautobodyandpaint.com. And if you want to learn more about VIP, you can go to this URL right here. I'm just going to put it in one shot there. It's super affordable. You learn everything about auto body and paint. All right. So let me try to get you a quick angle shot here. So I got my razor blade ready. Thank you, Big Apple. Right?
Let me see. Let's do it like this. See if you can get a good shot.
Again, this is going to be high def HD video in VIP. This is just the rough draft for you guys. But in VIP, you guys are going to get close-ups and a better angle of this. Okay, so the first thing, how often do I live stream? Once a week. Every Thursday, 8 p.m. Central. So we have our pinstriping. The first thing you want to do is get a proper length, okay? So I'm just going to say I'm going to come off and do a design around here, right? Hopefully you guys can see that. Turn it a little bit more. So I'm just going to say, all right, I'm going to use about this much pinstripe, okay? So we're just going to measure out the cab, maybe make it 12 inches longer or so. And boom, we have our pinstripe. Okay, so it's cut. Rips up super easy. What's up, Joe? Tony, Luke from South Africa, first live stream. Awesome. All right, when you're starting your pinstripe, you basically have a thick end and a thin end. Your idea, your goal in the beginning is to figure out what side you want on top and what side you want on the bottom. For me, I like the thicker pinstripe, the thicker vinyl on the top. Okay? So it's going to lay like this, the thick on top. Can you guys see that? Might be a little hard to see because it's so far, but thick on top is how I like to do that. All right? Now that we have our pinstripe cut, second thing you want to do is make sure your car is washed, cleaned. All right? If you have wax on it, you're going to want to make sure you basically wash your car with a non-wax car wash. Okay? Wash it down. And then you're going to want to use some Windex. You could use Windex or you could use glass cleaner. I like this stuff right here. So you're going to want to use a soft towel. You could use Bounty Max paper towel. They're very soft paper towels. I wouldn't use any cheap paper towels. What's up, Will, Todd, Peter, Claude? What's up? I wouldn't use any cheap paper towels because they might scratch your paint. Use a good, these are shop towels. These are very good, okay? And we're just going to clean the area. I already cleaned it, but I'm just going to clean it again. Clean where you think you're going to stripe, okay? And I'm just going to wipe the area clean. Along this top body line. And like I said in my other video, you want to always stripe following a body line. Because if you go off of a body line, it looks a lot nicer and clean. If you go in some weird design, it might not look right, okay? You want to make sure you go on a body line.
see some glue or something, make sure you get it off. That was some extra glue from the pinstriping that I did earlier. Okay. Maybe a little bit more in here. All right, cool.
Nice and clean. Now, what's going on? Okay, so we're gonna do a close-up shot now. We're gonna get a little closer. Okay, so when we get started, there is a backing sticker here, a backing paper that you want to peel off from the actual pinstripe, like that. Okay, you're going to have a clear plastic along the front of it as a protector. Okay, and yes, a lot of cars that I buy and sell for profit, I pinstripe to make them look nicer. So you're just going to want to peel it back like this, maybe about a foot and a half or so. Okay, and we're just gonna lay it on right on or below the body line, and I'm gonna let it overhang a little bit, and I'm gonna push on the corner. I always like to push at the body line seam here, and then we will start again. Okay, so let's bring this out a little bit. Okay. Now, let me bring the light over this way. Hopefully you guys get no glare. That might be good. Okay. Now I'm gonna go ahead and peel this back, and we're gonna do panel at a time. So now I'm gonna do my door. Because I pushed here, all right, I'll be able to pull it back a little bit. And then you don't want to pull too hard because you're going to stretch it and thin it out in some areas. You don't want to do that. Okay, so you want to make sure you're where you want to be on the body line. Okay, if you're going to be a quarter inch below the body line, try to match it up quarter inch below the body line, right? All the way down. Try to keep it even. So that's what I did here. Same thing. I'm going to pull back. Okay. And this is where it gets a little tricky on this truck because it goes up. So I'm gonna go ahead and go like this. Okay, and then it's gonna start to go up. So I wanna follow this line, this quarter inch line that I'm at, and just push slowly while push with my thumb, I mean, and just guide it back. And I might be getting too close to the body line here. Okay, but that's how it's gonna come out. And I am a little too close to the body line, but the thing is you could always peel back from the front and start all over. So let's get, okay. Let's get a little closer here. And I want this to come out nice. I want this to come out nice for you guys. So I'm trying to stay a quarter inch away, and I got too close over here. I got too close. So if we look up here, shit, my razor blade. If we look over here, here's the body line right about here. Okay? If I get a card or something, I could probably show you guys a little bit better. Let me get a yellow piece of paper. What's up, Brent Harper from Utah, VIP. Oh, maybe you're not a VIP. Okay, so let me show you the actual body line. Okay, this yellow paper will be on the body line. Okay, this is where the body line is of the car, the truck. You see that I'm about a quarter inch below it. You could be on the body line. you know, an eighth of an inch below the body line, a half inch below, but your main idea is to keep the same distance from your body line, which is right here. I'm right on it, right here with this yellow pad paper. Same distance all the way down. That's what you want to do. You guys are getting this? If you guys understand that, let me know. And once you do that, it's easy to keep everything looking sharp. And that's where it gets trickier, because if you see here, my body line is maybe 3/16 now instead of a quarter inch. You see how small it got? Like in the corner. Like if I go up flat here, it's the body line is right about there. So I have to kick back and make it a little wider. You guys getting this so far? Can you use dry ease marker to measure your spacing, then wiped off the marker? You could do, I mean, I've never heard of anybody doing that. The best way is to, I guess you could use tape and just do it on the bottom, but you're gonna be, it's the same process. If you're gonna be using tape, you gotta have to tape it on the body line anyway. It's easy with the proper lighting. You could see what you're doing as you're doing the pinstripe. So as long as you have proper lighting, like I said, you could just kick back and do it again. I mean, it's all about practice. So I have to kick it back. Okay, and because I stopped it over here, right, I could actually start all over again. Let me get rid of some of this white paper. We don't need it. Okay, so it does, you know, it takes a little time. Probably takes about 10 to 15 minutes per side, maybe 15 with the design. So let me just kick it back a little bit more, and we're just gonna follow through with that. And you just wanna make sure you get it even. See, I started going below the body line all the way back there. So let's see, I like to go like this. This is a tough one. Really? Yeah, very tough. Step back, please. Yeah, you just gotta eyeball it. Okay, so we're actually gonna go right around here and just go like this. We're actually gonna go a little less than a quarter inch. I'm gonna get closer to the body line. Maya, don't push down too much because I'm gonna take those off, take it off again.
Oh. Why are you gonna take it off though?
Because I have to realign it.
Oh, do it again.
Yeah.
Hi. Is it hard to do it, to turn it?
It's not that bad. I'll show you that trick in a bit when I start to turn this. So when you're turning it, you basically have to pull, stretch it a little bit, and use your other thumb.
Well, you're gonna go that high?
Not all the way up, but pretty much like that. But I'm not gonna go this high, I'm just testing it out.
Okay, so you could see how I made the corner here. Okay, you're gonna pull it and push with your other finger little by little. And if it doesn't seem right, you could pull it off, but if you end up stretching it too much in here, you could kind of screw it up. Then you're gonna have to redo it. So I'm gonna have to redo my front door again. I think this back panel looks okay. I really, you know, let me see. Yeah, I think the back door looks okay. It's just the front door I have to get closer to the body line now. Okay, hold on. Let me hit this front for these guys over here. They're watching. Yes, Maya, what's up?
Can we talk about the coop?
The coop?
Please, just A little bit.
Yeah, but they're trying to watch me do this.
She wants to tell you a minute about her chicken coop. Can she tell you about her chicken coop? Okay, go ahead.
Well, it all started with a couple of nights ago. We were up late and working on the chicken coop. My dad was cutting the wood and making where they lay the eggs. And then 2 days later, which was yesterday night, last night, me and my dad and my mom were up like at 2 o'clock in the morning still working about that. They made the door because there only was half over there. And then my chickens are sleeping in there tonight. Besides, instead of six, it turned out to be five because I don't know what happened to the sixth one. She's the noisy one, Ariel. She's really noisy. She would have been peeping by now, but we couldn't find her. We have a lot of hawks or whatever that's up there, so they probably caught her. But poor thing. That was my mom's favorite chicken. Well, it's not my fault. Well, she mostly blends into the dirt, but I guess it doesn't work. But my chickens are sleeping there tonight, and they're okay. We fenced the bottom, and my dad put some wheels on it so it can move. And they really love it. They feel like they're a safe home, and under the trampoline, we put some gate. We gate it around, so they'll go in there. They'll go right in there, and they love it. So I'll go to my dad.
Okay, great, guys. Okay, so here's what I did. Okay, so we're pretty much good on the body line here. Okay, we're good on the back. This area I'm going to design later, but let's go ahead and design the front quickly. Okay, so let's go ahead and figure out how we want to design the front. There was a design that I liked. Thanks, Maya. How is that lighting for you guys? The lighting okay?
Because I did do it.
Might be too bright.
Too bright? Oh, okay.
Should be okay. Yeah, you gotta watch out for owls and hawks. Okay, so now, this little film here, if you can see, peels off from our actual pinstripe. This white, clear film. So now I want to make sure I push firmly on here. Okay, like this. Okay, I'm going to push firmly. You could even use a cloth microfiber if you want to push it lightly. Okay, we're good. And then now I'm going to peel this clear off.
Can I try that?
You're a great assistant. Hold that. Okay, peel it slowly and come back till about here.
Okay, I'm good at that because I even did the plastic.
Yep, keep going. Okay, that's good. That's good. Now, I want to keep my main black line the same up top. Okay, I'm going to keep it coming forward. So what I'm probably going to do is just make a small little arrow, like I said I wanted to do, by pulling this off. Okay, and then I'm going to twist. I'm going to come down a little bit. And then maybe I'll just.
Wow.
Finish it like that. You know, it doesn't matter how you do it. You could make a bigger arrow if you wanted to, whatever you want. Inside, you could fill it up with a different color vinyl lettering if you, not lettering, vinyl sticker if you want to. But I'm going to run with this for now. It's simple, easy, and it's done. You know, I could have made it a little bit more aggressive. So here's the part where we're going to use a razor blade, which I have right here. So you're going to want a brand new sharp razor blade. Okay? And you got to be very careful. Okay? So what I like to do is just put it right over here. Okay? And just push. You'll just cut it just like that. Okay, same on this side. I'm going to have to just push lightly and cut it. It just cuts right off. Okay, and I'm going to have to just grab that piece in there. One piece is kind of floating in the back. I'm going to have to open the door and grab it. But that's pretty much how you do your edges. Okay. Guys, remember, I'm going to have this on HD video where it's going to be easier for you to see. Mm-hmm. Here in the front, it gets tricky because you could hold your pinstriping and have it cut with the razor, but sometimes it doesn't come out as good. So you're going to want to make sure to push gently. You don't want to cut through the clear coat. All right? Just be very careful. So what I'm going to do here is you got to make sure you push it on good. And I'm going to show you in close-up how this looks in just a bit. Okay? So what we want to do is I am going to...
Dad.
Yes?
The guy said awesome little helper. Besides, wish my kids were that interested. Well, I am super interested. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Bone. Now I'm going to cut the bottom piece very lightly. Very, 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 very lightly. Okay, you do not want to goof up on this part. Okay.
Since your arm was in the way, I just moved the computer up so they could see.
Okay.
What you were doing.
Is my arm in the way?
A little bit. I think you're fine now. See what I did? I did that for you.
Okay, guys. Here's the finished product on the front. Move back, please. Okay. Don't pull it all the way because I still have to push it. So how does that look? Can you guys see this? Here's the front. And when we back up, you're going to see how it looks as well. Don't worry. That'll come out. Okay. So it's simple. I could also run. What you could do next is actually even run this skinny line through it and continue it out. That'll look cool as well. You could put another skinny and fat line inside of it, whatever you want to do. If this was bigger, if it was a bigger arrow, or if it came out more, then it would look nicer to put more in it. But I kept it kind of thin and small, so it'll even look good as is.
They like it.
All right? So if we step back a little bit, you can see that it looks pretty sharp looking. Pretty sharp looking, pretty cool looking. Right? Now let's do the back. So before I do the back, I know it's a little hard for you guys to see. You guys liking this so far? Is it a little boring or is it cool or give me some feedback?
It's okay. You said it's boring.
It's okay to say it's boring.
Because we don't care. Because if everybody likes it...
I'll just go home and cry later.
No. If everybody was the same, that would just be a whole boring world. Ugh. So it's good to have good, bad, blah, blah, blah.
Custom touch. So simple. Love it. Great. So here's what I'm doing now. I'm peeling back the plastic here. Yep, you could peel it up to here. Peel it lightly and peel it straight. Straight, keep it straight. Little air bubble, we can heat it and push it down later. Okay, that's good. Stop there. Okay. Thank you guys for watching all my videos. Awesome. Okay, so let's do something cool with the back here. And then, again, don't forget, this is another important step. I've done pinstriping and then forgot about cutting here. And then I go open the door because I had to grab something in the car or something. I totally forget and it ripped the whole pinstripe off the car. You totally screw it up. So what I would do right now is basically just cut it. Okay, that's what I did. I just cut it. I just and cut it. So now, step back, Maya. Now if I open the door, right, you're okay. We're okay. So don't forget to do that. All right, and now when we peel back the clear layer, we're gonna peel it back from this side and then come back so we don't jack up our nice finished edge over here, okay? Cutting is the final process, but again, just make sure you don't do that. First time, be back next week. See you next week. Okay, so let's do something cool right here.
Is it true that owls eat chickens? Somebody, just whoever said, watch out for owls and hawks. I need to know. Because there's not much owls here, I think.
Okay. I think this looks pretty good. I think the back looks really good, actually. All right. So, the back looks good. Here's what we're going to do.
Let me move this right here.
Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and pull this off, and I'll be done very, very shortly. How long have I been on now?
About 30 minutes.
Yeah, about 30 minutes now.
I think I have a watch. All right, so, okay, so somebody answered me. Yep.
Okay, so somebody answered me. Yep.
Yep.
All right, so now what I'm gonna do is push down,
and I'll show you the back. Eyes hide out during the day.
Owls, can't read. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna push this. Okay, I'm gonna peel.
I am a really good computer holder.
If you don't push down before you peel, there's a big chance that you're gonna peel the pinstriping away from the panel, and you don't want that, okay? So make sure you push firmly and you push this down really good before you peel this clear film off. All right, so now that's done. Okay, now let's do our back design here on the cab. You could just hold that right there. I'll just do it right over here. I'll do what I did the other day, which looked really nice. It licked right into it. Okay.
I just holded the computer so you guys can see all good. Because sometimes I do that. Not really.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is, let's see if we should put the black to that, or...
There we go.
I wonder if... How did I do it the other day?
Yeah, okay, we will go black over the skinny, the thick over the skinny, and come down on the corner here. So hopefully that looks good. Okay,
I am a walking.
What's up, Rusty? Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna pull this back, and we are gonna go like this, and slowly pinch it off like that. We'll go a little bit. I think that's good right there. Okay, so this is what it's gonna look like. All right, so now I'm just gonna cut that with my razor blade. Mine, keep it steady, it's fine. It's cute. Because you're going all over the place and they can't even see it. So I'll just, what I'll do is I'll cut it and then they can see it. So let me just cut it here.
They can't see.
Yeah, I know they can't see it now, but.
You guys will. The owl's hiding today. Mm-hmm. Somebody said that I'm the best.
You're the best.
Yeah, I mean, look at it right there. You gotta look at it. You gotta. Just look at it, will you?
Maya's the best.
Oh, I have a YouTube channel. So whoever has kids can go on mine and learn about chickens, games, what do you call it? Farming, music, playing piano, voice, and all the other stuff that kids like. Oh, science. Yep.
Okay. One more cut.
Dad, I'm introducing them to the to my YouTube channel for their kids.
Great.
Yes.
I actually I like the way it came out the other day. Yes. I think I went in with the skinny over the thick last time I did it, and that looked a lot better. So I don't like this. So it's easy to redo it. You basically just peel it off. And start all over from here. Line it up and just redo it again. But that's how it kind of looks.
Looks awesome. Can you open the door?
Not yet.
Yeah, I'm here.
Don't push that. Hold on. Let me see something. Okay, this we could just push in quick. Open the door. That you could push in. So it gives you a nice professional finish if you take a look at that when you open the door. See?
This humongous truck. I'm driving this
humongous. See how that looks? Okay, nice and done well. Now you can wax the car. I would use a liquid wax, okay, and just go over everything after your pinstripe. You don't want to wax it and then do your pinstripe. So that's how it looks. Unfortunately, I don't like the way this back came out. I remember when I did it the first time, I overlaid the skinny onto the black so it had more of a lick to it. But that's, I mean, it doesn't look bad. If we take a look at kind of the side of the truck now, right? It looks different. And then we could do the bed, come down and do the bed. You guys want to continue and do the bed or just do some auto body Q&A? It's up to you. If you guys want to move on to the bed, we can do the bed, play around with the bed a little bit. If not, if you want to find Maya's YouTube channel for your kids, we only have one or two videos up right now. Well, we have an intro video and we have her first chicken video. It's you have to look up Maya Starla on YouTube.
Look, can you go what?
No. What's Maya's YouTube channel? My daughter would love to tune in. So you got to look up Maya Starla, M-A-Y-A-S-T-A-R-L-A.
But no space.
Yes, space.
No space.
Yes, space.
I did it with no space.
Okay, guys, so go on with doing the bed or just get into auto body Q&A. It's up to you. How do you prep your garage when you are getting ready to paint? How to keep dust low? Well, Jonathan, I usually make sure I blow out the shop, you know, the day before or the day that I'm going to paint. Blow it out really well and hose it down with water. Wash all the dust and just make sure it's all blown. And not only do I blow the floors off, I blow the walls off as well. My toolbox, and I just get all the dirty air out, the dust. And then hose the floor, and that's it. You're pretty much good. I like to keep my garage door open about maybe 20 inches, enough for a box fan to fit. And then turn the fans on, have the air venting out, and paint. You know, once you're in an enclosed area like this, it's not that bad. You're not painting in a windstorm. Don't push this dust into the car because it's sawdust. Any tricks for keeping dust out of paint besides wetting it? Damn, that was my question. Yes, with the space, it comes up on top of the list. With the space, Maya, it goes on top. So it's Maya. Yeah, don't push this because you're going to scratch the paint. This is wood dust, sawdust.
Okay, so what are they saying?
How do you fix clear coat when it peels off and leaves the base exposed? Well, you would have to basically sand it out. You have to feather it out, sand it out.
And
maybe you might have to lay a coat of primer on it. Depends. Maybe you could just spray base coat right over it, but it has to be wet sanded out. Have you ever used a ground strap to keep dust, attract static energy down? I have never used it. Sounds like a great idea, but I've never used that strategy. So we got a lot of questions coming in now. Should large sections of missing clear coat be covered with primer first and then sanded with 400 grit? Or is it okay to just sand the exposed base coat? Shoot. Well, I would first sand everything down, feather it, and maybe give it a light coat of primer if it's a large area. And then after that, water sand it with 400, get it all smoothed out, and then base coat and clear it. Can you turn out good paint jobs outside? Yes, absolutely you can. Make sure it's not in a season where you're getting a lot of pollen dust. You don't want to do it under a tree. Don't do it under a tree. Do it on a clear, clear day. Thank you, Maya.
You're welcome.
Can you clear coat over large vinyl decals, Fast and Furious style, on the side of a car? Yes, you can. Just make sure you clean it very good. What is the best base and clear for beginners? I think any base and clear coat can be for beginners. It doesn't matter. It's what's your budget, right? What kind of budget are you starting with? If you want to use the good stuff, use the good stuff. If not, you don't have to. I remember you said about having new pads for buffing, polish, wax, and you haven't mentioned since your video after the SEMA event. I'm actually still in the process of working on that. I will be talking about that. I'm just not at that stage right now. It's basically more foam pads instead of wool. We're going to be getting away from wool pads and more concentrating more on foam pads. So that's the difference. What's the best base and clear? I said that. Looking to two-tone a factory single door paint job. What grit sand? Look, I have her trained. What grit sandpaper to use to do this and have a good line? I'm looking to do a two-tone factory paint job.
I just do it on my own.
Well, you're going to 400 the car. You're going to paint one color graphic. You're going to use a fine line tape to mask it. And then you're going to paint your other color. There's no sanding. There's only sanding one time.
They want to buy a shirt.
Too many insects. It's too windy near my house to be able to paint outside. So try to get a tent or something or do it in the garage. 22 DVD set is awesome. Thank you. Can we buy a t-shirt? Yeah, you can. I actually have a campaign going right now. It's not this t-shirt, but it's this one here. And it's only up for another 6 days. I'll give you the link. It's the Boss Painter t-shirt. I'm still waiting for mine. I just ordered mine.
Why can't – I think they want to have this kind, Dad.
You guys can get this one, but it's – I haven't made these in a while. These are my original 2011-2012 VIP shirts.
Really?
Yeah.
That's when I was born.
Yeah. You were born in 2009. No, 2008.
Yeah, 2008.
Are they Meguiar's pads? Yeah, no, not really. They're another brand, a European brand.
European?
Yeah, European brand. You know, the problem is I've been contacting the people that I met from SEMA, and they just never contacted me back. I don't – you know, it's funny. When you go to events, you meet so many people, but – getting in touch with everybody again is so hard sometimes. So I've been having a problem getting in touch with those people.
How about every day you tour somebody?
So yeah, you could absolutely clear over decals. Have you ever used Amore Chemical Guys products and are they good? I have not, but I plan to. If they want to send me some stuff, they could send me some stuff and I'll check it out, but I have not. I know they have all kinds of chemicals. I saw some of the guys over at SEMA. They're just really into that whole line of products, you know. They have so much stuff. It's like overkill. I think they just have too much stuff, but it's working for them and they're selling a lot of it. So it's good marketing, right? They literally have every solution for every little thing. I think it's like overkill. I'd rather have one main wax for everything instead of, you know, a wax for your bumper, a wax for your fender, a shiner for your tire, another rubber sealant. You know, it's ridiculous, but that's them. I have my Boss Painter shirt right now. That's awesome because I don't even have mine yet. There's the Boss Painter shirt. Go get it.
Go get it. Go get it. Go get it.
What's up, Charles? Thank you. What's the best practice to do a two-tone fade paint job instead of solid? I want to paint from copper to a black top. So what I would do is paint the whole car black, or paint until where you want to go black, and then just copper, start coppering the bottom. And you're just going to have to fade it with your dust, with your spray mist. That's how you do a fade. You're going to have to make sure you just go straight. That's the only way to do a fade, is by hand. You're just fading it by hand. Yep. So that's that. So if you guys are liking it so far, give me a quick thumbs up. Should I continue and do the bed? Yes or no? Should I continue doing the bed? Yes or no? I'm kind of in the mode and I want to finish it. For all you newbies in here, newbies in the house, let me give you here's a t-shirt, guys, if you want to get a t-shirt. And here's a auto body manual, free auto body manual that you can download. And this is absolutely free. Okay, absolutely free. And I do hit you up with a special one-time offer to join VIP if you want to. Okay, cool, let's finish it up. So this is the free auto body manual. Let me get you the link to the Boss t-shirt right here. You could order it right now and you'll have it very soon. They basically print it and ship it out to you. I'm still waiting for mine. Okay, last question. Paint outside suggestion. If you want to paint outside, I suggest you get a 12 easy up tent, wrap them in plastic. And that's what I say all the time. I actually have VIP videos in VIP that show you how to set up your own homemade spray booth. Okay, so here's the t-shirt again, guys. Here's the link for the t-shirt. And here is the link for the free auto body and paint manual. And then I will finish off the bed. We will see what we could do with the bed. Probably another 10 minutes. No problem, Charles. I think it's not letting me. Okay, here it goes. Maybe I could post this. Anyway, it's not letting me post the link again. Maybe I just overdid it. But let's go ahead and do the bed. Okay, where is my Pinstripe? Where's my box? Here it is. Okay, let's just do the bed quick.
No, I just
want to sell it. Okay. I'm just going to go like this and like this. Super short.
I'll get your laser rigger, whatever. Here you go. I put it in the safe.
Okay, leave it right there for now. Thank you.
Right here?
Okay, again. That's good. Maya, it looks like you've been touching the truck. Yeah, your fingerprints are all over it. Don't wipe it with that. I got this right here.
I did not touch it. Now I do?
No, not with that. Final with this glue. Okay. Great. Let that air out for a second. Guys, is the chat working? Okay, the chat's working. Hey man, just signed up yesterday. Love your videos. Awesome. Appreciate your help. No matter if they don't have the VIP, I'm a student of automotive, so not too much money spent on an international student here in US.
I'm gonna tell them to do the thumbs up.
Okay.
Everybody, there's 54 people, 52 people watching now. So I want you guys to do it, to thumbs up to up to 53. Okay? I want to see that right now. Right now. Good, thank you. Come on, 45. It's not going up. I don't see anything. Okay, I just did like Allie now. Oh, 46, awesome. 47, awesome. Just six more thumbs up. Four more thumbs up. Just four more. Five more. Six more. Four more. Hurry. It's keep going up, down. I don't know.
I just think they're hitting it again, and then it's just taking the thumbs off. If you guys double hit it, it comes off.
So just keep, whoever didn't do it, it just happened again. Okay, just four more, you guys. Just three more. Two more. Just two.
Wow, you did pretty good. You got him to go all the way to two more.
Just two.
Maybe there's not enough people on the line. I don't know.
Somebody says, sorry, Maya, my phone wouldn't let me do a thumbs up. Okay, it's okay for you, but just two more, guys. Just two more. Okay, just one more. One more, I guess. All right, so anybody who didn't do it, come on. Oh, they said, see ya, Tony, I have to go. Oh, whoever said that, the video is a repeating thing, so you could just see it over and over, so
recorded,
you wouldn't miss it.
Recorded.
It's recorded. Okay, so somebody said that. I'm awesome. That's awesome. Oh, and Mario Kart. Oh, never mind about that one. Some left already. All right, 58. Just one more, guys. Just whoever didn't do it, just one more. Just one. Whoever did it. It's easy. Just one clicking. That's it. Just one. Yes. There's 56 people, 55 people watching, but a 57.
Wow, that's unbelievable.
Weird. But that's awesome.
Okay, guys, I did it. Now we're just gonna figure out how we wanna end it and start it. Okay, because obviously starting it like this is gonna look kind of stupid. Okay, so we got around our gas cap. We got the side of the bed. Okay, the back I'm usually pretty good at. I was also thinking of coming down and then coming back up. We could do that, but I have to take off this clear plastic, and I'll do that right now. So let me take off this clear plastic here. Okay. Let's take this clear plastic off here. Hold on, I got it. Okay, peel that back slowly. Slowly with the pinstripe. You want to go along the lines of the pinstripe like this. Okay, go ahead, go back. And they can see. No, you want to push before it.
Oh, okay.
Push before, like this. There you go.
So like that, you guys. And
so easy, a kid could do it.
Yeah, even.
And then grab it again. Grab it again. It's getting long. Grab it again.
I think even a four-year-old can do this.
Okay, and you could just go like this, and we will design the back later. Okay, we'll design the back part later. But I'm thinking right here, I already have an idea. I already have an idea here. We could probably just go. So where's my razor blade? My razor blade?
Right there.
Okay, so let's just see how this looks. Okay, we're gonna cut these so I can open and close my gas cap. See how nice and professional that looks right there? Okay. Now we're gonna go ahead and just cut this line here. The video might be bad. Yeah, I love Maya likes to get involved, so.
Of course I do, I'm a master. Ooh, I have my own Pinstripe part.
Okay, hold on.
Now this is just getting better and better.
Hold on, Maya. I need to light my.
Okay.
Okay. How does that look for the back? I think that looks different. We have the lick down and a lick up right there. I want to do that door over. I don't like the way this ended up. But you can kind of see how it looks from the side. I think it looks different. Okay. The back, I have another idea. I usually like to end the back kind of like on a straight tone, like going straight off. So I might, what I like to do is usually get the fat and come down a little bit. So let's do the back. Let's do the back here. You could also end it. It depends if, see, I originally wanted to do something coming down here and then coming up, something extravagant. Let's try that. Okay, let's try that. So, give me some more Pinstripe. See, hold on. Originally, guys, I wanted to come down with the fender line here and then come up, make a point. So let's do that. Okay, let's just try to screw around with that. So I need a small piece coming down and then another piece going back. How long do you want a piece? This is like this? Yeah, okay. Because this is, I use this stuff. All right, let me get the light over here. This is a pretty long. Okay. I don't know if the, that might be good, that lighting. Just trying to think how I should do this. So let's just, yeah, it's going to have to be two pieces if I do that. So here's what we'll do. It might be too glary like that. It's too glary, huh? Let's go this way then. Oh, it's still glary. Does that work? Okay. Straight back looks great. Yeah, I think straight back looks great as well. But let's do something playful here. So I'm peeling another piece. Okay. And I am going to connect it to my original line up over here. Man, I am kind of sad how this lighting is looking.
I don't like the way the lighting looks.
Maybe that looks better. You guys tell me. Simple and clean.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is follow my original pinstripe right here. And instead of going doing what I did, I'm going to come down now. Okay, so I'm going to actually come down. I don't know if you could see this, but I want to make sure I don't screw this up. Hold on. See, your imagination is your only limit with this stuff. I need to concentrate. No. Please. Okay, so we kind of follow the line here. Okay.
Yeah, that's way too much. I don't know if I'm gonna like that. What's up from Texas?
Yeah, that might look funny, but we could do it. It just might look funny. I'm just talking to myself, guys.
Yep, he does that well. Next
one. I'm just trying to see this in my... in my mind's eye here. Mind's eye, my brain, you know, in my mind. Then it's just gonna look funny. I'm just gonna have a thing over here. I think it looks good straight back, honestly. I think it looks good straight back. Farther back leading off the tee, because right now it's following the flare curve. Farther back leading off the tee. Oh, I see what you're saying. Like, you mean from here come down? I wanted to do something like this. It's just, you know, you don't know until you start screwing around with it, right? And honestly, I think it looks good just boom, straight like that. It looks better than I expected. Okay, so I can come like that. Trying to figure out the sleekest line. Looks cleaner with a straight line.
Yeah, I know. But it's not done though. You know, I had a, let me see. Because you could do all kinds of stuff with this.
I
mean, I can just totally screw it up and just mess around with it, but I don't know if I want to do that. But it does look good. If I peel this back and just end with a straight line, I think it looks good. Maybe we'll do that. I won't even screw with this.
because it's just too much noise. Too much noise. What I'll do is I'll end off here like I usually do. So I'll come back here. Too thick. That kind of looks good. So we'll just end it like this. And again, you guys, you can always change it and screw around with it later when you have time, when you're working on your stuff. But for now, we'll just end mine like this. Okay. Again, you could do it however you want to do it. You could have ended off straight. You could have come down and did like a backward arrow. I could have done, you know, whatever. I was thinking of doing something coming down like this and then coming up, but I think it looked a lot more streamlined and simple just starting over here. Right, we got our gas cap working fine and just peeling off straight cut to the back. I think that looks the most cleanest. I think it still would look good just by ending straight, like a lot of you were saying. But you could also do like a little, you know, some sort of cheap design on the back. I mean, it doesn't look cheap. It actually looks good. I could have came down a little more. Obviously, it's all up to you. You know what I mean? Just wanted to give you guys some quick ideas on what can be done. So that's pretty much it. We did the pinstriping here. Hold on, I'll show you from front to back what it looks like, you know, and you tell me what you think. So we got the front here, right? We got our little arrow that we did. Comes across, it ends on the cab. I want to redo that back cab a little bit, change it off to where the fat overlaps the skinny, so it hicks out a little bit more, not the skinny coming into the black, to the fat pinstripe, more so to say. And then we got the back looking like this. So simple.
Look at what I did.
DIY pinstripe, and Maya did an awesome job pinstriping
on
my mirror. Look at that. That looks amazing.
Like I did it this like you. First I did it like this, made an arrow.
She is so hands-on in DIY. Middle. It's crazy.
And I also did another one, and then I did just that, and I just messed up. I did something on the bottom.
Thank you, Maya.
Bye. Like my video.
Hey guys. Yeah. Do the offset closer to the off-road. Yeah, that would have been different too. Offset it all the way back. Do you mean come down here by the off-road and then come down all the way? Is that what you mean? Make this longer? Looks better than mine. Joe said it looks better than mine.
Really?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Anyway, guys, I want to say thanks for spending over an hour with me tonight on here. Obviously, these shows are only about a half hour long, but I wanted to do something with you guys and do a full pinstripe job. It usually takes a lot takes a lot less time. But we were talking and doing all kinds of stuff. So the end should go up. The end should go up around tail light and around the back. Yeah, that could happen. But that can happen. But you mean like come up here and then come up and then go around the back? You know, whatever. Whatever you want to do is what I'm saying can be done. So if you want to do that in your truck, go ahead. You guys are awesome. So anyway, guys, here's the free auto body book. Hopefully it goes through. Have a great night. Thanks for getting on. We're going to be back on next week, Thursday at 8 p.m. Central. Here's the free book link. Let me also get you the Boss Painter t-shirt link. Hold on, Maya. I'll let you say goodbye as well. I'll let you say goodbye. Okay, Boss Painter t-shirt link right there if you want to get it. It's only going to be up for a couple of more days. The little flare at the end looks good. Great job. Enjoyed Maya and Tony's show. Thank you, guys. So, guys, thank you so much for getting on. Hit the like button if you haven't. If you already did, no big deal. I will see you guys on next week, Thursday. 8 p.m. Central. Thank you for watching, guys.
59 thumbs up and 45 people watching now.
That's great.
Besides, I did something new with the paint.
It looks great.
Because I just made this.
It looks great.
Next time I'll show you guys how I did it.
Wow, this is crazy looking. It looks like a Spider-Man mirror. Kind of. That's true. Not really Spider-Man, but it doesn't look like a web. It looks like futuristic.
That's true. Well, good night and good night.
Where do we submit videos for testimonials? Oh, let's talk about that really quickly. So VIP members, we are doing a video testimonial contest. I'll give you the link where you could learn more. Here's the link. And you're basically going to submit the video. You're going to upload it to YouTube. Upload it to your account. Check out this page here. This is only for VIPs. You're going to upload it to YouTube and you're going to send me the link. Okay. Myself and my staff, we check out our emails every single day. It's tony@learnautobodyandpaint.com. tony@learnautobodyandpaint.com is where you're going to send us an email and email me in. Send me a link to your video testimonial. All the instructions are on this page right here. And it's going to end in about 10 days. I haven't been promoting it as hard because I'm so backed up and busy with stuff to do. But I will start promoting it very, you know, within the next day, tomorrow, and I'm promoting it right now. Be sure to do that. Send in your auto body and paint testimonial for learnautobodyandpaint.com saying, hey, as a direct result of Tony's Auto Body and Paint course, I was able to ABC. You know, whatever your fantastic results were, even if it was just giving you the confidence to get started, okay? Because that's really all it is, you know, getting started and getting things done.
Besides, what people are really afraid of and a lot of people do is they're just afraid. They just don't, they have something they want to do, but they're just afraid. They could have just done it, right? Oh, well, goodbye, people.
All right, guys, good night. Thank you so much. Don't forget to check out those URLs that I sent you for the testimonial contest. You're going to win a free spray gun if you have the baddest assist spray gun. Sorry for my bad word. What? Good night, guys. Have a great night. See you on next week. Ciao. Ciao, ciao. Ciao, ciao.